You are watching video on SEE examination preparation grade 10 exam subject science. This is the solution set of model set 2076 SEE examination. We are going to discuss answers of group A questions in this video. These are 1 mark questions in group A. Question number 1A, what is the relation between gravitational force and distance between two bodies? Gravitational force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between two bodies from the formula F equal to g mm by d square, or F is proportional to 1 by d square. So force is inversely proportional to the distance, square of the distance. So this way, if distance is smaller, force is bigger. If distance is bigger, then force is smaller. So inversely proportional. There could be similar type of questions this way. F equal to gmm by d square, or F is directly proportional to product of the masses of two bodies. So gravitational force is directly proportional to the product of the masses of two bodies. So similar type of question could be like this. What is the relation between gravitational force and masses of two bodies? So if the question is like this, then your answer should be force is directly proportional to the product of the masses of two bodies. Question number B, what is the renewable source of energy? Renewable source of energy. The source of energy which can be replaced immediately or renewed easily by natural ways after it gets exhausted. Exhausted means finished. It is called renewable source of energy. The source of energy which can be replaced immediately or renewed easily by natural ways after it gets exhausted is called renewable source of energy. Example, solar energy, hydroelectricity, biomass energy, etc. So similar type of question could be like this. Non-renewable source of energy. The source of energy which cannot be replaced immediately after it gets exhausted. Non-renewable source of energy is stored in the nature over a long period of time. So this way, non-renewable source of energy cannot be replaced immediately after the source of energy gets exhausted. Question number C, define heat on the basis of molecular motion. Heat is defined as the total kinetic energy of the molecules contained in a body. Total kinetic energy of the molecules contained in a body. This total kinetic energy of the molecules contained in a body. So this is definition of heat on the basis of molecular motion. Similar type of question could be like this. Define temperature on the basis of molecular motion. So answer is temperature is defined as the average kinetic energy of the molecules. Average kinetic energy of the molecules present in a body. Question number C. Now question number D, what is the center of curvature of lens? The centers C1 and C2 of the spheres whose parts form a lens are called centers of curvature. So this is lens, this figure is lens. This lens is made up of two spheres, and this is one sphere, this is another sphere. Okay, so there are centers of the sphere here in this way. C1 and C2 are the centers of a sphere. So these centers are called center of curvature, centers of curvature. A lens is made up of parts of two spheres joining with each other this way. This is the lens. If you produce this lens forward, then it will make a sphere, and in the similar way, this is the lens, part of the lens, side of the lens. If you produce this side of the lens in this way, then it will form a sphere. So this way there are two spheres and there are two centers of the spheres. These centers are called centers of curvature. Okay, so centers C1, C2 of the spheres, of these two spheres, whose parts form a lens, are called centers of curvature. And the line passing through centers of curvature is called principal axis. This line passing through centers of curvature of two spheres, this line is called principal axis. What is electromagnet? Question number E, 1E. Electromagnet, a solenoid or conducting wire conductor, behaves like a magnet during the flow of an electric current through it. When current is flowing through a conductor, it behaves like a magnet, and this is called an electromagnet. This is called an electromagnet. It is a temporary magnet. Okay, solenoid is a spiral arrangement of a conducting wire. A spiral arrangement of a conducting wire is called a solenoid. So it is it looks like this. This is the spiral arrangement of conducting wire, which is called solenoid. Now next question is F, in which group of modern periodic table are the elements with valency 2 kept? So this is the question. In which group of modern periodic table are the elements with valency 2 are kept? So if you have to say modern periodic table, then group 2a in metals and group 2a 6a in non-metals. 6a in non-metals. So these two groups have the elements which have valency 2. Okay, so group 2a and group 6a are the elements with valency 2 in modern periodic table. Similar type of questions could be like this. In which group of modern periodic table are the elements with valency 1 kept? So from group 1a metals, from metals group 1a, from non-metals 7a. These group of elements have valency 1 in modern periodic table, if valency 1 is asked. Now if valency 3 is asked, then group 3a and group 5a. These two groups have valency 3 in modern periodic table. Okay, so here in your question, group 2a from metals and group 6a from non-metals are the elements with valency 2 in modern periodic table. Now question number G, define alkali. Define alkali. Hydroxides formed by the reaction of bases, water-soluble bases with water. Base plus water forms hydroxides, and hydroxides are alkali. Hydroxides are alkali. Bases means metal oxides. Bases plus water. Base plus water gives alkali, and alkali is hydroxide. For example, magnesium oxide is metal oxide plus water gives magnesium hydroxide. Magnesium hydroxide is an alkali or hydroxide. Alkali or hydroxide. Okay. So a similar type of question could be like this. Define bases. Bases, metallic oxides and hydroxides are bases. Metallic oxides and hydroxides are bases. So this alkali is also base actually. It is a kind of base. Okay. So these are the questions. Now we are going to see next question, that is number H. Which metal can be obtained from hematite? Iron is obtained from hematite. Hematite is the chief ore of iron. So similar type of questions could be like this. From bauxite, aluminium is obtained. From copper pyrite or chalcopyrite, copper is obtained. From argentite, silver is obtained. Okay, so these are the chief ore. Bauxite is the chief ore of aluminium. Copper pyrite or chalcopyrite is the chief ore of copper. Argentite is the chief ore of silver. Okay, similarly gold can be obtained from alluvial soil or quartz rock. So these are the ores from which these elements can be obtained. In your question, iron is obtained from hematite, or chief ore of iron is hematite. Now next question is, write any two examples of alkane. Alkane general formula CN H2N plus 2, general formula of alkane, CN H2N plus 2. So examples of alkane are methane, ethane, A-N-E suffix, A-N-E-A-N-E, methane, ethane, propane, butane, etc. And alkene, if alkene is asked in the question, then general formula CnH2n, alkyne, general formula CnH2n minus 2. Right, so this could be asked in the questions. Alkene, examples of alkene, methane, ethane, alkyne, examples of alkyne, ethyne, propyne, butyne. So these are the examples. So here in your question, examples of alkane are asked. Examples of alkane are methane, ethane. right? So if alkene is asked, then it is going to be methane ethane. If alkyne is asked, it is going to be ethyne propyne butyne. So in which plant Seri silkworm feed on? Seri silkworm feeds on mulberry leaves. Mulberry leaves, kimbu. Mulberry leaves. Similarly, another question could be like this. Airy silkworm feeds on castor leaves. Castor leaves. So these are the similar type of questions. Now next question we are going to see is this one. What is the name of the valve found in between right auricle and right ventricle? The valve is right. The name of the valve between right auricle and right ventricle is right atrioventricular valve. Right atrioventricular valve. Right atrioventricular valve. These are together. Right atrioventricular valve. Auricle ventricle. This is also called tricuspid valve. Okay, similar question could be like this. What is the name of the valve found in between left auricle and left ventricle? The valve is left atrioventricular valve or bicuspid valve. Left side bicuspid, right side tricuspid. So you have to remember this. Now we are going to see next question, that is question number L1L. Right, karyotype of Klinefelter syndrome. Karyotype of Klinefelter syndrome is the karyotype of Klinefelter syndrome in sterile male. Sterile male means the male who cannot do reproduction. Sterile male is 44 plus XXY. So there is one more additional sex chromosome in case of Klinefelter syndrome. There should be only one X in the normal case, but in Klinefelter syndrome there is an additional sex chromosome. So 44 plus XXY is the karyotype of Klinefelter syndrome. There should be only one X actually, but being an abnormal, it has one more X. Okay, normal is 44 plus XY. Abnormal in case of Klinefelter syndrome is 44 plus XXY. So similarly, the questions could be like this. Other questions, Turner syndrome. Karyotype of Turner syndrome in case of sterile females, 44 plus X0. So there is absence of one sex chromosome in case of Turner syndrome. That is why it is 44 plus X0. In case of Down syndrome, 45 plus XY in male, 45 plus XX in female. Okay, in case of autosomes over here, yes. So there is one more chromosome. There is one more additional chromosome in 21st pair of chromosome, 21st trisomy. Down syndrome is also called 21st trisomy. There is an additional chromosome in this case. In place of 44, it is 45 here. Okay. For male, it is 45 plus XY. For female, it is 45 plus XX. Okay. So these are the karyotypes of Klinefelter syndrome, Turner syndrome, and Down syndrome. Write the name of two growth hormones used in vegetative reproduction. So the two growth hormones used in vegetative reproduction are auxin, which is the root, which helps in root growth. Okay, rooting hormone. Cytokinin is the hormone which helps in stem growth. Stem growth. So auxin, root growth, cytokinin, stem growth. There is one more hormone which is used in vegetative propagation, that is IBA, indole 3 butyric acid, which is also a rooting hormone, root growth. It also helps in root growth, IBA, indole 3 butyric acid. Now the next question is, write two natural sources of air pollution. Natural sources of air pollution are forest fire and sand and dust from barren land or desert. So forest fire, it produces carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, smoke from forest fire. And another one is sand and dust from barren land or desert. And another could be volcanic eruption, large amount of smoke is produced from volcanic eruption. And livestock means cows and sheep also produce methane gas. And methane gas is also one of the, you know, this is greenhouse gas. Okay, so other examples could be like this, but the easier ones are forest fire and dust and sand particles from desert and barren land. Question number O, what is the time period of Cenozoic era? The time period of Cenozoic era is 65 million years ago to the present time. 65 million years to present time is the time period of Cenozoic era. Okay, this is the current one. This era is going on, Cenozoic era. We are living in Cenozoic era. So similar questions could be like this. Azoic era or Precambrian era, 4600 million years to 570 million years. Paleozoic era, 570 million years to 225 million years. Some books write this as 250 also, but 225 is also correct, 225. 570 million years to 225 million years. Mesozoic era, 225 million years to 65 million years. So these are the time periods of different eras of geological time scale. In our question, time period of Cenozoic era is 65 million years to present time. So with this, we finish discussion of group A questions. We are going to do group B, C, and D in upcoming videos.